This is Su Yun, and I work in an NGO called Coffeelicious. Due to my research, I think that coffee should stay on the market, but under certain circumstances, like buying fair trade and shade-grown coffee. Listen more to find the truth behind coffee plants. Then you'll know why this shaman should be used. Versus coffee, and mostly all people around the world use it. Everyone knows that we consume it, but there are other ways to use it. It can be used as an organic flea dip, spread on the garden for fertilizer, or feed worms and more. We as people need this resource because it costs a lot of money, which helps the economy and farmers. Fun-grown coffee makes an impact on food chains and ecosystems, like clearing the rainforest, which decreases the number of population of every organism. If worse, it can lead to global warming. In Central America, over 25 million of forests were cut for fen coffee, and farmers use pesticides on the plants that lead to bioaccumulation. Fen-grown coffee is better than sun-grown because of the Inga tree. The genus Inga tree can reduce the impact because it has lots of shade, fixed nitrogen into soil, and birds love these trees for their nectar and a smorgasbord of insects. Tree can reduce the impact on this rainforest food chain by making a habitat for the organisms like birds and have an increasing population or have a right-side biomass. These shade-grown coffee plants are much more eco-friendly than sun-grown coffee. Did you know that farmers aren't paid a fair wage? In addition, even children do these labor. Most farmers are forced to do this because they're paid sooner, leaving the choice to work for them. If they refuse, they get beaten up. This prevents children to get educated, not able to get better jobs than picking coffee. They don't even give enough money for the extraction and production they did. This is called as an externalized cost. Profits go to brokers and middlemen, but workers live in poverty. This could be called as the coffee crisis. According to my information, the regular price is lowest is 25 cents, but the highest of fair trade price is $1.35. This is why the coffee crisis isn't ending. People aren't paying the true costs. We can't leave them in poverty forever, but it can stop if we keep buying fair trade certified coffee products. $60 billion were sent to African farmers for emergency. This could end the poverty for some farmers, but not all. As I said, buying fair trade coffee could change their way to fair trade for money. This lets the farmers earn 3 to 5 times more money than others who aren't paid fair. In addition, this can block the coffee crisis. Use coffee in a more socially sustainable way by using or buying fair trade certified coffee. If we keep buying fair trade coffee products, then other companies can also change into fair trade because the demand changed into that. Or buy Rainforest Alliance certified products. This makes money more given to the farmers than the middlemen. As I said, in order to keep our earth sustainable, we should keep coffee in the market, but in certain conditions, like buying fair trade and shade-grown coffee. To the consumers out there, I recommend that you should buy shade-grown, fair trade certified, or Rainforest Alliance certified coffee products to benefit farmers, the earth, the rainforest, and the animals.